triple fucking six.
Yeah, nigga. The motherfucking two-time motherfucking champion is in this bitch. I got another motherfucking gold plaque on the wall now, nigga. Now tell me, what you think about that? Look me in my eyes and tell me, nigga. Bitch.
Big money, big cars. Who the fuck you think we are?
We living like superstars. Right, motherfucker? You bring it, motherfucker. Come on with it.
He's battling Jim like a duel with ping, 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 tennis rackets versus a skateboard and shit.
Do it!
Motherfucking Baker.
Clear as day. She's finally gone.
All right, here's these.
I got my first video camera when I was 15 years old, and then that's when I would just film my friends and they'd film me, and then I made some videos from VCR to VCR. When I was 17 years old, so I used to love like ollieing off roofs and shit. One time I tried to ollie off this roof, and that was the one and only time I actually broke my ankle, landed like a ballerina off the roof. That's when I became a stoner. That's kind of how I ended up hanging out with Andrew and all them, because they were always just smoking weed. We lived right next to each other on Warner Avenue in Huntington.
The porch on my room and the porch on his, like, his house connected or something like that. He'd come over and smoke some weed with us, and he skated. He was filming Brad Hayes at the time. He just filmed, you know, whatever was happening. So it would almost be like go unnoticed, you know?
That's when I started filming Baker 2G. I just had this eye just to capture like hijinks also. Shit that's going on like around the skate spot, just film that too. And they're like, damn, he's got a good eye for these hijinks. Ever since then, just making videos with them, and it's just been a dream come true every day. Can you see this? All right, right there. Like, look at that tongue. Like, you see that? It's uncontrollable. They call that a mob face. I got like the worst mob face in the world. And the reason behind that mob face is like, there's so much concentration put into the angles to make everything look as big and good as possible that it's like, whenever full focus is involved, I gotta like tweak my face out, because if I wasn't, like, if I was filming like this, then I'm not filming that hard. There's not much thought into it. Like, no, hell no, I gotta get in there, you know?
What up now? Yeah!
Beagle's just like a special human being. That dude busts his ass every weekend, comes and picks us all up, drives everybody around all day long, people in different cities, people whatever. Everybody drinks and smokes and does whatever they do, and he puts in the 9 to 5, but then puts in an extra fucking 5 hours every day just because he has so much love for the game.
Without Beagle, there's no Baker. He is Baker, you know? He's like as much Baker as any of the riders.
Beagle's always been the go-to guy, no matter who it was. Jim, Andrew, Eric, like, he's always been the go-to guy, like, for spots and everything. If you know a basketballer, he's like Phil Jackson. You know what I mean? Like, you still got Jordan, you still got all these amazing players, but without Phil Jackson, it never could have assembled the way it assembled. So he helps pushes you, and it's like, I'm saying, he's like Phil Jackson us, you know? He's like the wizard. He's the Zen master.
Motherfucking Beagle Hammer!
That scene in Baker 3 where that dude is like, give me the camera, give me the camera.
Huh? Give me your camera. Hey.
You know, the whole situation kind of reminds me of that movie, Dusk Till Dawn. These vampires use the strip club to lure in all these truckers, and then they just jack them and shit. But that's kind of like what this spot was like. It was like a random, like a curb off a three stair that some like gangsters probably just waxed to make it look like appealing so we could film there. And then it's like a trap. My friend Jeff just runs in the street like a quarterback with the fucking camera. And then he notices this like G-Ride with the hazards on with other like shady people. So he runs back over past the first guy.
Beagle, wait, going the wrong way. Those essays in this car, stop.
And then the car pulls out, makes a U-turn and drives in front of us and then parks. And then they get out of the car, these two Mexican dudes. So they got us all cornered.
Should we just leave it up? No?
I run out to the street, and there was this fucking red Honda going really fast. And that fool was all fucking loked out, too. He almost ran us over. There's one more car that's about to come by us. And my friend Jeff is like, gets in front of the car like, stop! And the car pulls over, and it's this big buff dude in an El Camino. And he's like, get in. And we just jumped in the fucking El Camino. And we're like, whoa, what the fuck? Like, who are you? He's like, Salvador. And we're like, Saint Salvador, dude, you just saved our lives, man. Holy shit.
He's just put here to film for Baker. I don't know, we went and looked, though, like, Baker 3 and Baker 2G and all the videos and the tour videos, they wouldn't be what they are without him, you know? It's like, he captures more than just people doing tricks, you know? He shows what we're all about and all the funny stuff that happens, and you know, he just he's a genius.
Yeah, Beagle can get crooked cab.
Of course, I just love the VX1000 right now because the handle on top just keeps it all steady and it's got like the best fisheye. I don't really see any other cameras really better than that. Everything else is kind of just for filming movies and stuff. They made the VX1000 to film the Desert Storm Gulf War because it was just like easy to maintain and shit. So it's like I really am in the fucking Desert Storm dodging boards and shit. Once the VX is completely extinct, if that ever happens, then maybe we'll switch to HD. And luckily, Andrew and everybody on Baker doesn't care about high definition, so we're just gonna swerve using the high def camera for as long as it takes.
It glistens, don't it? It glistens, don't it?
The VX is just like made for skateboarding. Yeah, it's pretty cool that the kids don't have to buy the Baker video, they can just get it with the Thrasher magazine. Because a lot of the kids that like Baker are pretty hood, you know, and don't, you know, have much money to spend $25 on a video. So we're doing it for those kids. Ah, shit. Hey, well, I'm gonna go right now. I gotta finish this Bacon Story video. All right, peace out, dog. Thank you.